My name's Brian. I'm here to tell you about something that happened to me a few weeks ago. But first, a question. Isn't it truly amazing that your life can be turned upside down in just 1/10 of a second? It can. And soon, you'll find out why. Let's not bore you with a lot of details about my life. I'll cut to the chase. I was born in New York 23 years ago, and growing up, I was always somewhat of a child prodigy. I studied at Columbia and finished my physics degree with honors last year. During the summer, I arranged interviews with several universities, hoping I'd get into a decent PhD program. And in the end, I was chosen by the best. Professor Silva at Berkeley offered me the chance to do my doctoral studies at the Applied Physics Department he runs there. It was a dream come true. I packed my bags and got ready to move to California. I was ready to drive from coast to coast without stopping. I had no idea of the events that would take place within just a few days. About the mess I was gonna get in. Strange people about to cross my path. The hundreds of dangers lurking behind every corner. Yes, it's quite an adventure. Let's go back to the beginning. As I told you, my old car and I were ready to go to California. I decided to take off at night and get a few miles behind me before dawn. I said goodbye to my parents, my sister, and my dog, and I got behind the wheel. That's when I remembered I forgot to pick up a book I'd ordered at a bookshop downtown in Manhattan. Luckily, it was one of those bookstores that stays open 24/7, so I decided to grab the book on the way. I could have asked them to mail it to me once I got to California, but no, I decided to go into Manhattan and get it myself. That one detour changed my life forever.
Oh my God!
Stay away. It's better if they don't see us.
She's unconscious. I'm taking her to the hospital.
We'll take care of her at the hospital.
Me
Maybe that moron did the dirty work for us and she's already dead.
Maybe, but we'd better make sure.
It did. I'm telling you. On the way to the bookshop, I hit that girl with my car. I was scared stiff. She suddenly ran out in front of me. There was no way I could stop. Luckily for both of us, she wasn't that badly hurt. They did a bunch of tests on her at the hospital and said she had no major injuries. She was just in shock. So they decided to keep her under observation for 24 hours. A nurse took her to a room and gave her some strong medicine that put her to sleep. By the way, I don't know if I mentioned it. The girl's name was Gina, and she was amazingly beautiful. Is, I had no reason to stick around, so I went to say goodbye to her and go on my way.
Please, don't leave. They want to kill me.
There, calm down. It's all over now. I hit you with my car, but you're fine. You're in a hospital recovering from...
No, I'm telling you, they want me dead. I've got to get out of here.
Who are they? Please, calm down and tell me why you think they want to murder you.
Something awful happened tonight, and I witnessed the whole thing. Look, I'm a singer. I work at the Pink Iguana, a trendy place with live shows. This evening, when I finished my act, my dad was waiting for me. He works for a secret government agency. He told me he needed to tell me something. He said it was an emergency.
Come a little closer.
Gina, kiddo, I'm in danger. I've gotten into a really big mess, and I'm afraid you're not safe either.
What's the matter, Daddy? Oh, you're frightening me.
There's no time to explain. They're right behind me. I need you to keep this crucifix, and no matter what happens, don't let them find out you have it. You can't trust anybody, not even the police.
But, Daddy, please, tell me what's going on.
They're here. Quick, grab the crucifix, and don't let them see you with me.
It was awful. Some guys pulled my dad away and took him into the storeroom. I scrambled away just in time and got the crucifix without them seeing me. I followed them to the storeroom. They tied my dad to a chair and violently started interrogating him. These two henchmen wouldn't stop hitting him, and my heart froze when I saw who was giving the orders. The Sandretti brothers.
The famous mafia bosses? How'd your dad get mixed up with those guys?
I don't know, but they...
Get him to tell you what he knows. Beat the truth out of him, if you must.
Speak. Where is it?
I won't say a word, damn you! You're gonna speak now. Speak or die. You choose. Go to hell!
It seems our friend doesn't want to cooperate. What a shame.
So, we got a tough boy on our hands. You're not easily convinced, huh? Boys, maybe you're being too soft on our little hero.
Did you hear that? The boss says we're being softies.
Hi-ya! What are you doing?
Didn't you hear his neck crack? You killed him, man.
Up there.
You already know the rest of the story. I ran out through an alleyway, and when I crossed the street... Please, don't leave me. They'll kill me.
Don't worry. Just rest for now. Go to sleep. I won't leave you. She fell asleep. Those tranquilizers must have taken effect. What a story. I don't know what to think. The poor thing is probably in shock from the accident. I bet she dreamt all this. But what if it's true? What if her life really is in danger? I can't just leave her here and forget all about it. I'd never forgive myself if something happened to her. Okay, that's it. I'm not leaving this hospital until I'm sure Gina's completely out of danger. But how are you supposed to act in a situation like this? Yeah, I think I'd better do something to protect Gina in case those mafia murderers she says want to kill her show up.
So, und damit hallo und willkommen. Wie ihr seht, diesmal kein Wolfenstein oder ähnliches, sondern mal etwas in einer ganz anderen Richtung. Ein Spiel namens Runaway Road Adventure. Relativ altes Spiel. Wow, und ich sehe gerade, dass die Grafik hier ein bisschen rumspackt. Ich habe es, um ehrlich zu sein, bisher noch nicht ausprobiert. Ich habe es nur im Steam Store gesehen und habe mir gedacht, geil, das muss jetzt einfach mal sein. Ist auch blöderweise momentan noch auf Englisch. Ich werde allerdings mal schauen, dass ich dafür vielleicht was hinkriege, dass das Ganze auf Deutsch ist. Aber nun gut, wie dem auch sei. Ist auf jeden Fall ein sehr cooles Spiel. Es geht im Endeffekt darum, dass meine Story, habt ihr jetzt alles halbwegs mitbekommen. Die gute Gina hier wird von der Mafia verfolgt, weil sie etwas gesehen hat, was sie nicht hätte sehen sollen. Dementsprechend werden wir jetzt einfach mal anfangen. Wir müssen die irgendwie aus dem Krankenhaus rausholen, damit sie entsprechend in Sicherheit ist. Kurz gesagt. Oh, doch, genau, kann man so sagen. Ich muss dazu sagen, ich habe das Spiel schon einige Male gespielt. Das letzte Mal ist allerdings schon ziemlich lange her. Deswegen, man muss hier ab und zu mal so ein bisschen Rätseln kombinieren etc. Ein bisschen, was weiß ich noch, vieles leider nicht mehr. Dementsprechend kann es sein, dass es ab und zu mal ein bisschen schneller vorangeht, ab und zu mal ein bisschen weniger schnell. Aber das werden wir einfach mit der Zeit sehen. Wir fangen jetzt einfach mal an. Ihr seht also, es ist im Endeffekt ein einfaches Point-and-Click-Adventure. Das heißt, also ich kann hier angucken, ne, sag mir. Genau, dann sagt ihr mir immer schön, was die Sachen sind, kann aber auch einfach zum Beispiel versuchen, die Sachen zu nehmen. Das heißt, also wir werden einfach mal zwangsläufig alles nehmen, was wir uns nehmen können. Und danach mal schauen, was wir damit anstellen können. So, da haben wir noch was. Können wir uns auch noch nehmen. Glaube ich zumindest. Blub, blub, blub. Na, die Pillen können wir uns auch noch nehmen. Wunderbar. Ja, ja, dann wollen wir mal ins Badezimmer gehen. Und schauen, was wir hier noch so finden. Das nehmen wir uns noch mit. Und ansonsten noch irgendwas anderes, das wir uns hier mitnehmen können? Ein Stift. Ach, genau, 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 genau. Bisschen was fällt einem doch da direkt schon wieder ein. Okay, was anderes können wir daraus anscheinend momentan nicht gebrauchen. Okay, das Schränkchen ist abgeschlossen. Dann schauen wir doch mal hier draußen weiter. Okay, in den Flur kann ich auch nicht. Dann gucken wir doch mal in unserem Inventar. Was haben wir denn jetzt? Wir haben zumindest schon mal eine Tasche. Mal gucken, vielleicht ist da ja irgendwas Interessantes drin. Was wir noch brauchen. Streichhölzer. Okay. Alles klar, also ist noch eine Menge Kram drin, aber nichts, was wir momentan gebrauchen könnten. Dafür haben wir leider keinen Schlüssel. Alles klar. Fenster, mal rausschauen. Kann ich nachvollziehen. Würde ich auch nicht rausgehen wollen. Okay, sie schläft noch. Was haben wir denn sonst noch zu tun? Auf die Karte gucken. Okay, ist also noch ein Lagerraum. Direkt neben unserem Krankenzimmer hier. Vielleicht. Nein. Okay, also auf dem Flur will er auch nicht, weil er Schiss hat, nach Hause geschickt zu werden, beziehungsweise weggeschickt zu werden. Ach, also aus dem Fenster geht, ja? Davor hast du dann keine Angst mehr. So. Krabbel, krabbel, krabbel.
Yikes! I better not look down.
Das denkt sich irgendwie jeder, aber trotzdem macht es immer jeder. Nicht nach unten gucken. Das Erste, was gemacht wird, ist, wird nach unten geguckt.
Let's see what I can find in this dump.
Na, dann schauen wir doch mal. Buch?
I may be needing this.
Ah, vielleicht. Kissen.
I'll take them both. Well,
kann man ja alles mal gebrauchen.
I don't need any of that.
Irgendwo noch was?
I'll grab one.
Eine Spritze.
I think it weighs too much.
Piece of paper, kleines Stück Papier, eine Krankenakte. Ja, genau. Ah, Erinnerung kommt so langsam, aber sicher doch wieder zurück.
Okay, but I think I'll just take his head with me. His head's got a hole in one side, so you can examine his brain.
Ew.
I don't think I'll be needing.
Davon was? Okay, das will er nicht. Was haben wir da noch? Sprühdose. Ja, das ist wie in vielen Filmen oder sowas auch. Hatte ich, glaube ich, letztes Mal in irgendeinem Teil von Wolfenstein schon mal erwähnt. Man erkennt das teilweise immer schön daran, dass manche Sachen so aufgehellt sind. Dass man da irgendwas zu machen oder zu klicken hat oder sonst was. Das finde ich immer ganz lustig. Erleichtert einem die Sache. Gemein, okay.
I don't know what's inside. It's I don't want to catch some tropical disease.
Okay, das will also auch nicht nehmen. Dann scheinen wir hier momentan, glaube ich, erstmal alles zu haben. Oder? Na, ich glaube, was haben wir da noch? Nichts, was wir anklicken können. Dann wollen wir erstmal wieder zurück. Kann er jetzt mit ihr sprechen? Nein. Auch nicht. Okay, wollen wir nochmal anfangen? Ich weiß zumindest noch, dass wir irgendwie alles in einem läuft das später so ab, dass wir hier eine Figur hinlegen und irgendwann auch, glaube ich, auch noch den Flammenmelder hier aktivieren müssen. Okay, wird zumindest schon mal durch Hitze aktiviert. Das heißt also, dafür werden vermutlich die Streichhölzer und vielleicht sogar, ja, das Spray hier gut sein. Okay, jetzt wollen wir erstmal schauen. Finden wir jetzt noch was Interessantes dran? Ah, noch eine Perücke. Die kann man doch bestimmt. Jawohl, ja. So. Okay, das will er nicht. Das will er auch nicht.
Great. This marker's as dry as a bone. It won't work.
Okay, ist trocken.
This marker's too narrow. I need a This
Was?
Marker's too narrow. I need a way to funnel alcohol into it.
Ah. Das klingt doch.
Now the syringe is full of alcohol.
Schon fast logisch.
Betcha that put some new life into the marker.
Wunderbar. Jetzt kann man auch drauf kritzeln.
Can't tell the difference between this and a real chart.
Na?
I don't like that. Good.
Jetzt schauen, ob wir da einfach die Figur so hinbasteln können. Scheint zu klappen.
With the wig and a sheet to cover it all up a bit, I can make it look like a woman is sleeping here.
Wie gesagt, also müsst ein bisschen entschuldigen, ein bisschen was weiß ich noch aus dem Kopf von damals. Aber ich gehe mal davon aus, das ist nicht ganz so schlimm. Dann brauchen wir ja teilweise auch nicht ewig lange für irgendwas.
Perfect. That way they'll think it's Gina who's in the bed.
Okay, jetzt haben wir es auf jeden Fall schon mal bewerkstelligt, dass jeder, der hier reinkommt, denkt, dass da Gina liegt. So, jetzt müssen wir nur noch wissen, wofür das gut ist. Hier rum, komme ich da jetzt nochmal dran? Ne, finden wir in der Tasche noch was Interessantes? Okay, also das Kruzifix, aber das holt er nicht raus. Irgendwo anders noch was übersehen? Oder einfach nur ins Badezimmer gehen, auch gut. Kommen unsere Mafia-Brüder. Tony Crab? Ob denen auffällt, dass da trotzdem eine Frau liegt mit dem Namen Tony? Anscheinend nicht. Ja, scheinen wir auf jeden Fall schon mal irgendwas richtig gemacht zu haben.
Gina! Hey, 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 hey!
Scheint auf jeden Fall noch tief und fest zu schlafen.
But those tranquilizers must have been made for elephants. Well, the important thing is, the trick worked and they shot the dummy in the other bed. So everything Gina told me was true. They actually do want to knock her off. It wasn't just her imagination. Okay, let's calm down, Brian. Right now, they think she's dead, which will buy us a bit of time. But we can't waste a minute. I gotta wake Gina up, get her out of this place before they find out she's alive and well.
Okay, nächster Schritt ist, sie aufzuwecken, um ihr abzuhauen. Ich weiß, dass noch irgendwas mit der Sprinkleranlage war. Macht er das jetzt einfach? Na, um sie aufzuwecken. Deswegen solltest du das tun. Will er nicht, okay. Mal lesen, vielleicht steht da noch irgendwas Interessantes. Ach, das ist ja das, was ich geschrieben habe, ich Idiot. Das ist sehr nett, dass wir das jetzt wissen.
Gina! Gina, wake up! It won't work. You can't get her to wake up like that. Try to figure out what it says about Snoozetol, the sleep medication that Gina took. It says the effects are powerful and almost immediate. The patient sleeps for hours and can only be awakened by a nice cold shower. I don't think I'm strong enough to lug Gina into the shower, so I'll have to come up with another way of pouring cold water on her.
Irgendwofür ist immer irgendwas gut. Na gut, also er hat jetzt durch das Buch herausgefunden, dass Gina nur durch eine kalte Dusche oder irgendwas mit kaltem Wasser jetzt geweckt werden kann. Und ich wette mit euch, jetzt geht auch das hier.
Good idea.
Ah, wunderbar.
I can use it as a flamethrower and make the sprinkler go off. The water would finally wake Gina up. Let's get to work. But careful, Brian, don't broil your hand off. Ouch!
Das Bettlaken will ich mal sehen, was so schnell in Brand kriegt, nur wenn man einen Streitschalz drauf hält.
What's going on? This water. The smoke. Fire!
I'll tell you later. Let me grab your stuff. You can change in the car. Come on, let's get to the parking lot.
Style. First you try to run me down with your car, and then you save my life. Do you do this kind of thing very often?
No, I was just...
It's a good thing that you grabbed my purse, because otherwise we wouldn't have the crucifix my father gave me. Now, what we have to do is...
Headed for the nearest police station. This is a very serious matter, and it has to be placed in the hands of the police.
No way. Let's keep the cops out of this, okay? If the government gets caught up in this, we don't know if we can trust them.
Gina... People that killed your father after you now. If we go to the police, they'll make sure that...
Read my lips. No, this is too big for the police, and we can't trust them. We have to find out what this crucifix means.
Look, this all seems crazy to me. It's your problem if you decide not to turn to the police, but I'm washing my hands of the whole affair. I'm on my way to California. They're expecting me at Berkeley, and...
I can't believe this guy. You practically turned me into roadkill, and now you want to feed me to the wolves? And here I was actually starting to believe you.
But...
Forget it. It's not worth it. Why would you care if my father was killed? Why does it matter to you if I'm murdered or if my whole family's destroyed?
Okay, already. Let me tell you what we're gonna do. I have a friend who's an anthropologist. He works at the Museum of Archaeology and Natural History in Chicago. since it's practically on my itinerary anyway, I'll drive you there and we can try to figure out more about that crucifix, okay?
I knew I could count on you. You're a doll. Start this baby up. We can't waste any time. Hey, do you know where my blonde wig is? I was carrying it in my purse, and now I can't seem to find it.
Have you confirmed that?
Yes, Don Roberto. Gustav is at the hospital right now. He's checked up on it. I can't see how that girl escaped. Looks like the guy who ran over her is along for the ride. They left the hospital together.
Useless idiots. Have you identified this man's car?
Yes, Don Roberto. We know the model, color, and license plate number.
At least you've done something, Theodore. Meet with Gustav and be prepared. As soon as we locate the vehicle, you're gonna go after them.
Whatever you say, Don Roberto. I assure you, we won't let them ditch us again.
I hope not.
Don't worry, Roberto. Those two couldn't have gotten very far.
Carlo, you know I'm thinking something here. I'm almost glad that girl's still alive.
What do you mean? That girl witnessed what happened, and if she talks, we're in big trouble.
I know that. But it's obvious she hasn't gone to the police. I wonder why.
I don't know. Maybe she's there right now.
I'll bet you $1 she won't stew on us. You know why? Because she knows something. I think our men spoke with her before that animal Gustav broke his neck. Besides, why else would she have been in the storeroom?
Yeah, you may be right, brother. In which case, we gotta make a spill the beans. See what she knows.
You're right, Carlo. We'll do that. Now we gotta get out the warning to all our boys out there. Make sure everyone's on the lookout for that car.
I guess there's no other excuse for getting involved. Gina had me dazzled. I can't deny it. But what would you have done? A beautiful girl asks you for help, so what do? Kick her out of your car on some corner? I don't think so. It took us a whole day to get to Chicago because the old hunk of junk I drive is no race car. Along the way, we stopped to have some snacks and keep the car from overheating. We took turns driving so both of us could get in some shut-eye. We got to the museum pretty late, but my friend Clive knew we were on the way, so he waited up for us. Well, we made it to the museum. Let's park in the back.
Munchkin Blob here. I'm calling from Chicago, and guess what? I just saw that car you're looking for. I swear I haven't had a drink, and I'm sure it's the same car. Yeah, a dopey-looking guy with some gal. They went into the Museum of Archaeology and Natural History. Sure thing. I'll tail them.
So, you're trying to find out the precise origin of this crucifix. It must be quite important for you to have come all the way here at this time of night.
It really is, Clive, but there's no time to explain. What can you tell us about the crucifix?
I can assure you it's a matter of life and death.
Well, all right. Let's see. Quite a while ago, the museum trustees acquired the latest three-dimensional scanner for the museum's analysis laboratory. It's capable of analyzing the composition of any object, dating it, and performing a morphological study in order to catalog it. It has the most thorough art and archaeology database that exists in the whole world. We could most certainly use the scanner to delve into the origin of the crucifix.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go straight to the lab now.
Just one moment. Not so fast. Our first predicament is the poor condition the crucifix is in. It's obviously coated with a layer of filth that will make it impossible for the scanner to perform an accurate analysis. We must restore the crucifix first, if the scanner is to work properly.
Well, let's restore it then. You can do it, can't you, Clive?
I'm afraid not. I'm an anthropologist, not a restoration specialist. That sort of job must be performed by Dr. Oliver, the museum's finest art restorer. She just happens to work down the corridor at the restoration laboratory. She's there at this very moment.
Yes, let's go talk to her now.
Hold on, there's another problem. In 3 days, the museum will be opening an exhibition on Mayan art. We're already behind schedule, and Dr. Oliver is overwhelmed with work, trying to restore all the pieces for the exhibition. I'm truly sorry, but you'll have to wait for the doctor to finish her work before having the crucifix restored. And I doubt that will happen for at least 3 days.
3 days? No way! I can't wait 3 days! Professor Silva's waiting for me in California and...
This is unbelievable, Brian. You're already thinking of leaving me here defenseless?
No, I wouldn't do that. But I can't wait for 3 days either. I'm gonna talk with this doctor and try to get her to restore the crucifix tonight.
Oh dear. You can try to, Brian, but I'm warning you. Susan Oliver is not an easy woman to sway. If I were you, I certainly wouldn't dare make such a proposition until she's completed all her work for the exhibition.
Well, I have to try. You said she was next door, right?
Yes, through the first door on the left when you leave my office. Good luck, my friend. You'll be needing it. Listen here, Gina. What do you say if we take a little stroll around the museum and I show you some of its hidden mysteries?
A stroll?
I see you haven't changed a bit, Clive. Anyway, we'll meet up here in a little while.
I don't know. Well, all right. Let's take a stroll.
Hello? Dr. Oliver?
Yes, who are you?
Pleased to meet you, Doctor. My name's Brian Basco. I brought you an object to be restored. It's a crucifix, which...
Listen, boy, this wretched son of Utsitsa has taken me 2 weeks of work to finish. And all of the numbered objects on these shelves here have to be restored by the time the Mayan art exhibition opens in 36 hours.
But this is an emergency, Doctor. There are lives at stake.
My life will be at stake if the items on those shelves aren't ready for the exhibition, all right?
So, Hallöchen. Da sind mal wieder ein, zwei der. Wir machen jetzt allerdings erstmal Feierabend. Wir haben jetzt, haben es geschafft, lebend aus dem Krankenhaus zu entkommen, sind hier jetzt im Museum, um herauszufinden, was denn mit unserem Kruzifix los ist und was es damit auf sich hat. Natürlich nach wie vor immer noch von der Mafia verfolgt. Aber wie es weitergeht und was es mit dem Ganzen auf sich hat, das sehen wir dann in der nächsten Folge. Also erstmal wieder vielen Dank fürs Zuschauen und bis zum nächsten Mal dann wieder. Tschüss!